What is good, friends? We are here with ABR versus Zamrock. This match doesn't matter, but I don't care. I am hyped. I don't care if this match matters. Let me just close my Discord real quick because I don't want lag. So ABR brings some weird semi-stall or balance. I don't know how to call it. And Zamrock brings some triple water. It would be interesting to see if this is double call mind, maybe. I think this is the move Kaldia. So Volcarona is a threat, so this could be Scarf, Nihiligo, Roxalandris, Mega Scissor obviously. I think it's Protoninja. I just think Protoninja is better, and it also makes sense because it could be hazard stacking, because Zamrock doesn't like Defog Scissor, so I don't think this is Defog. So this would, if this is Rocks and this is Spikes, hazard stack kind of makes sense to me. So yeah, this match was supposed to happen tomorrow, but yeah, I don't know what I'm playing today. I mean I'm not complaining, I'm hyped. Hyperstall. Ultra Beast Hyperstall. Cake. Man says three Ultra Beasts, yeah. And then three Fat Mons. Cake. I mean, this is also potentially fat. So looking at ABR's team, I really don't know what to say about this team. I just know this is... I think the Faramosa or the Celesteela could be the Z-move. Like Supersonic Skystrike Celesteela is a cool set. So Zamrock leads off Nihiligo. I think he's Scarf Nihiligo. Maybe I could make an aggressive play and stay, and that Celesteela was so obvious. Okay, he's Rocks. He's the potentially the suicide lead. So the Landris could be Earthplate or Double Dance. Since this is the Rocker. I wasn't sure, like I thought this would be Scarf and this would be the Rocker. I mean, the Landris could also be the Scarfer. But I mean, it would make sense to me if he's not Rocks on Landris, he could be Double Dance Landris with Z-move, and he could be Scarf Keldeo, because earlier I said he was Z-move Keldeo. But yeah, now that it's out that he doesn't have the Rocks on this, this could be Scarf, this could be Double Dance. So Leech Seed coming out on the Greninja. Heavy Slam doing a nice 5 to his Suicune. Scarf Suicune with Fast Suicune with Substitute would be nice to see. And yeah, he does reveal the Substitute. And if the Clefable is... Okay, the Clefable is Rocks, so it's probably Knockoff in the last slot. I've played ABR on the ladder and he had Knockoff Rocks Clef. So ABR is gonna like go for the... try to PP stall us out of Scalds, I guess. So like Zamrock has to Scald burn this. ABR is in Encore, that's a nice set. Wait, what did he say? CBB? Does CBB run this set? TDK. CBB or TDK. Let me just check if I'm recording everything. Good, good, good. I don't want to mess up, dude. Yeah, Zamrock gets a burn on Mungus. I think Zamrock can just stay in here. He doesn't lose too much from staying in. ABR's only potential healable user is Clefable, which I don't think he is. Yeah, I think would be clutch for Zamrock. That doesn't break the sub. Among Us is weak as piss. I mean, he can just go for Substitute again when the Encore ends. Actually, yeah, he can go for Sub now. This is looking bad for ABR, like... Yes, Quacksay can kind of stall this, but... Okay, it is the Protect, so this is Wincoon, however you call it. So yeah, he only has 4 Encores left, Charlotte's Pressure. I mean, now he's obviously gonna like comment up again. Man, Samrock is going in on this guy. And we don't see a point of ABR's team. Like, why he brought this specific team versus Samrock. Lol, Blunder said he thought that Encore had 32 VP. Wait, if Samrock wins this, it's 9-0. Is it 9-0 then? Cryonicles are like destroying the Alpha Runers. Yeah, this match is over. Like, what? The Suicune set is really good, and I kind of want to build a team with T-Spikes and Heligirl plus the Suicune set. I don't know if NJMP built this team, because I know he likes the Suicune set, or he... I don't know if he used the Suicune set before, or if he built with this set before. I think he likes it. Yeah, I think he built with it before in Auras, and with T-Spike support from Nidoqueen. Okay, there's no burn, so... I guess he can spam recover a few times here and hope he doesn't get burned. I mean, also Clefable, not Clefable, just burn in general, burn being nerfed is nice for ABR, because even if the Quick gets burned, it just cancels out the leftovers. So yeah, Zamrock had enough, he didn't want to get PP stalled out. Yeah, I was about to say he wanted to build with this Steve Spine and Heligo plus this Suicune set. And I was also waiting for for NJMP to build with this set. Because he was mentioning that when he was talking about all the months when Sun and Moon came out. Like when the months were not even out, but when we had the stats for the months, he made like a video with Ricardo. Yeah, like I said at the beginning, it could be potentially CM spam. Nice play by Abra, yeah, for sure. Thank you. So, this is Coleman and it doesn't have lefties, so... It's probably, whatchamacallit, it's probably Z-Move Keldeo. And then it's probably Scarf Landorus because he needs speed control, right? I mean, he has Bullet Punch on this. Greninja is decently fast and could have Shuriken, but still, a Scarf is always nice. If Ricardo or NJMP made this, I'm pretty sure that it has a Scarf, because... I mean, just in general, it's SPL. People know that speed control is kind of important, right? Wow, goes to Celesteela there. Did he predict the Scizor? I mean, nah, the Keldeo was locked into Encore, so never mind. It's not like he made some Jesus-esque play, but... So it's fast Scizor. Actually, never mind. Celesteela is just super slow, so he would have to run super fast Celesteela to outspeed. But yeah, just in general, I know Zamrock will run enough speed on this to outspeed like Magnet Zone for sure. Unless it's Scarf Zone, which is not a set. Scarf Zone is not a set. I mean, Scarf Zone obviously outspeeds it, so... Scarf Zone is so weak, don't use that one, trust. It doesn't even outspeed anything. And AV and specs are just nice. Compared to Scarf Zone, like, Scarf Zone doesn't even outspeed, the new Pokemon Tapu Koko and all that stuff. Ninja. Tornadus, I think it also doesn't outspeed Tornadus, it's like really slow. It barely outspeeds 110 Pokemon, I don't know if it outspeeds Starmie, which is 115 if I recall correctly. So this Greninja is getting pretty low now. Celestial beats it when we won easily with the Leech Seed Protect combination. I could see maybe I'm going for Leech Seed again here. I'm pretty sure he's going for Leech Seed again. I know this guy. He's good. Okay, okay, he switched out. Okay. So I think this Clef is gonna go for knockoff. Yep, yep. Told you this guy. Like I told you. So it's Scarf and Heligo. Scarf, Stealth, Rocks and Heligo. That's actually that's actually a really cool set. I know this NJMP team was. I think it had the Dragalge and a Vinkun, or was it a Nidoking and Nidoqueen and Auras? And it had a Scarf, Rocks, Garchomp, which was really cool. I loved that team. I didn't use it, but I loved watching tournament games with that team. So the Landorus is not Scarf then. I take that back unless it's double Scarf. The Celesteed is really obvious, so I don't know why he doubled into Lando. I mean, Yanhiligo is also decent play by ABR as with this Sludge Wave. That's leftovers Lando. Okay, that's interesting. Is it? It could be substitute. Cause I don't think this is T spikes though. That could be the sub toxic Landers with Earthquake, and I don't know if it runs Smackdown. But I think that set was also used in that team in Auras that I mentioned. That team with with Dragalge. Oh my God, that did 5 bajillion. Is that specs? APR said the only set. Wait, what is the switch into this now? I mean, okay. I mean, APR is obviously forced up a bullet punch, but I could see APR pulling a really aggressive play and staying in. Because Celesteel on the back is obvious. I could see Zamrock Roost here make an aggressive play. I think he's roosting. Okay, he just played it safe, okay. I mean, I can clearly understand playing safe there. Blender said, cool, we won one. Because it's like 8-0 for the Cryers at the moment versus the Runers. So like the series is already decided. I think it's 8-0, maybe it's 7-0. I'm not gonna check this during the game. I mean, everyone's just gonna go for Leech Seed here, I think. And Zamrock is probably gonna go to Suicune. What is this Scissor doing for Zamrock? Let me look at it this way. Does he need a Scissor for anything? I mean, Bullet Punch is obviously nice for things like Formosa and Nihiligo. And it also roots on the Clefable if it doesn't have a fire move, which I don't think it has, because it's Stealth Rock knockoff healing move and probably Moonblast. Moonblast is needed on that set with rocks to force out Sableye to get up rocks versus like feather teams, and Zamrock brought a Sableye last week, so that would make sense. Ah, nice, they're having a conversation. Do you like my team? What I was trying to say is this is as nice to keep actually when I look at, because it roosts on the Clef and it roosts on the Quack, but I guess it roosts a burn on the Quack. Just returning is fine. So he sucks to Greninja, that makes sense, because Greninja kind of got walled by the Celesteela. Oh, he got a Spidef drop. He is Spidef boost, he ain't dying now. Man's is gonna eat. I mean, Suicune gets a free substitute, yeah. Yeah, Zamrock said Yumingoon, gag, the counter. Like, he countered this, what ABR said. Wait, what does blunder mean? When I said this is unlosable, okay. Like, I don't know why he said they win 6 over Celesteela. I mean, yeah, if... yeah, if he stalls the Silicon out of PP, I guess, but what I'm trying to say is, Silicon gets a free sub on this. Did she... yeah, he gets a free sub. Like, this cannot break the substitute. Like, what? Why did he stay in? I guess he just gained some more lefties, so maybe I didn't lose anything from staying in. And yeah, I think Zenbrook doesn't have enough Scald PP to beat this, so Abia will PP stall this, and I kinda get what Blunder said. I can understand, but what I meant is Celesteela in general doesn't beat this Silicon, but yeah, he can obviously just PP stall it. With the Among Us plus Quagsire combination, which is the nice and core used on standard stall, ABR stall in Auras. Yeah, that actually did nothing. Like, oh my gosh, that Scald did 23. That is fucking 5. Yeah, Zamro is not winning with the Suicune, especially if it doesn't get a burn. Yeah, I think Blunder's right. I think the Abia wants this pretty much. I mean, Abia has 3 ultra beasts, so if Emok realizes there's no point in staying in. Like, the 3 ultra beasts are like that. If you like do a shot on live with that, you can always say beast boost if you're pokey. Nah, Zenbrook is not gonna comment this time, I think. Yeah, he's just like Fuga says, how long is the play? Oh, we don't see how Zenbrook breaks the Among Us. Like, at the beginning I thought he just wins with the Kuhn, but I guess I was wrong. You don't beat a player like ABR just like that. Who did ABR play last week again? Was it P2? I think that was 2 weeks ago. Oh, Mans went for Pump, that did 5 million. So this Clefable looks to be really fist off. Cause it's not spec scale, the only revealed command. I mean, maybe it's a roll to kill the Clef from here. Maybe I will know if it's a roll, he can just calc. And if it's not a roll, he can just softball, because no one hits a pump and crits. Like, no one hits 2 pumps in a row and crits. I mean, I got some respect for Mans ABR trying to win this for his team when they already lost the week. Yeah. Too bad I missed Blunder vs. Poi. Actually, it's better that I missed it. Blunder would have gone mad at me when I uploaded that match. Ouch, ABR gets this special attack drop at Moonblast. Mans putting 3. Mans with a triple. I don't know what's this. What is this called in English? I just know a dot. I don't know what this is called. Comma? Is it called comma in English too? I know it's called comma in German. ABR 30% dot. Yes, see, CMing there, I can actually get behind CMing there. I mean, yeah, I was about to say that you can just crit him, and this guy said that thought the same in the chat. Yeah, he can live another one if he comments again. And this time he doesn't get. This time he doesn't get the drop. I was actually wondering what the land was. Yeah, that's interesting. Yeah, we will. Like, it would be interesting to see if it's like, if it's like substitute with toxic. Or maybe it's SD. SD leftovers, I don't know. So, Thermos obviously outspeeds Kelly and can just fire off a U-turn. If he's expert built or black belt, he can also just go for a sweep with this kind of. Now the Suicune is too healthy. The Suicune is too healthy to go for a sweep. But if he like kills this, gets an attack boost, I can imagine Suicune takes a shitload from plus one HJK. Okay, goes for the rapid spin kill, that's an option. I mean, if ABR is not choice, he can kill us with Ice Beam here. Do we know if the... What was ABR's in Heligo? Nah, Heligo. Yes, he's substitute landers, they call me the prediction god. Subtoxic, didn't I say that at the beginning? Cack. I mean, my like some sets are pretty wrong, obviously, but yeah, I was expecting this set probably with SmackDown. Yeah, with SmackDown exactly. I just know because a team kind of like this was used in Auras. Why didn't he do this 50 turns ago? And I said we should have lost. Yeah. Toxic to Formosa right now. Do it. Because he's expecting Earthquake. I mean, can't you sub again if you're Zamrock? So you avoid the 50-50 if he goes Formosa or anything. Did he toxic? Okay, sorry. I mean, that did a shitload. Wait. Did I say it was a 50-50? Did I say that? I hope I didn't say that, RIP. I think I said that, RIP. I'm bad. Man's HJK to Landris, Man's is real. Didn't want to let a Scizor come in, the Scizor coming in potentially an Ice Beam, I think. Oh, the Suicune, yeah, well played ABR. Yeah, Suicune makes more sense. I don't know if Scizor even takes two Ice Beams after Rocks. Or, it probably takes one, but then it dies to Rocks next time, probably. Yeah. If he sent that Landers in 50 turns earlier, he probably won. I mean, yeah, this Landers set is really nice, but I don't know if he would have won. I'm not gonna, like... I don't think I'm in a position to say, to talk shit here. Like, actually, I didn't mean to talk shit, but what I was trying to say is that sentence made no sense. What I was trying to say is it's 4 a.m. here. I don't think I'm in the right mind to like give the best analysis. Cack. What is wrong with me? I recorded a lot of games today. Stay tuned for that, friends. I will just upload this immediately after because this game is hyped and I think people would want to see this. And there's only 131 users online, so lots of people have missed this one. HJK did a lot to the Landers. Yeah, nice boost, and now he's forced and what, he gets a speed boost? Doesn't Nahiligo usually get a special attack boost? Kek! This man is not max special attack. Tanks plus one vogue, HP grant. So he's HP invested? 176 special attack AVs. Man says. Man says you outspeed it regardless. There's a high chance of okay. It was forced to bullet punch there. Zamrock doesn't really have a win con. Man's ABR just played as well. Like, the Landorus could have been a bit annoying to AVR, that specific set, but I don't know if it would have won him the game. Yeah, this Silicon just gets PP stalled now. Like, I hope they don't play this out, cause this is gonna be, yeah, I hope he just forfeits, cause this would take a few minutes to PP style of Skulls. But yeah, I like this game, but it was weird. Like, grass not Nihilico. What is that for? For stuff like Gastrodon? That did a lot, what the fuck? And that Skull did nothing. What, does Nihilico the god? Is that for stuff like Krexa, Gastrodon? What else does it hit? Oh, it also hits Keldeo. I don't know how heavy Keldeo is though. Let me see data Keldeo. Yeah, man's just wins with his Nihiligo. Nice, so I can put a Nihiligo on a thumbnail. Amazing. And what are we gonna put into the thumbnail for Zamrock's team? I'm gonna put a Suicune, I guess. So they could have a chance to win this. We can put a Greninja too. Yeah, this was a cool game. My analysis wasn't on point, but cool game for sure. Mama, like, get this, like, upload this ASAP for you guys. I'm gonna make a thumbnail and everything. And I think Exp Shine's game is in 45 minutes, 5 AM my time, they call me no sleep. I actually got a lot of sleep yesterday though, so it's fine, don't worry friends. Like, I'm not collapsing here, like, it's weekend, I could afford to ruin my sleep schedule again. I'm gonna have to, like, see how I stay up on Monday. Heck, that's gonna be wild. Thank you guys for watching, stay tuned, I will have a lot more coming, like I said earlier. I recorded a few games, I recorded like a few Ubers games yesterday, a few Ubers games, I think one or two Ubers games today. I recorded Black and White, and I always upload the Black and White and the Ubers games after. I just push out the Sun, Moon, OU and the Auras ones first. So yeah, we can look at the score again. It's at 7-0 here, I'm pretty sure it's 8-1 now. Actually I don't want to spoil the score, like I don't want to spoil any specific games, so let's not look at the score. I think I uploaded any, like a few of those games. Okay, it's still 7-0. So it's not updated. Oh yeah, New Breed 1 versus, I forgot his opponent, but it was like Gen 3 or Gen, I think it was Gen 3. So yeah. What is important, Cryonicles won the week, Cryonicles have a chance to make playoffs, so I hope they make playoffs. there's like some really cool dudes on there. And peace out, friends. I don't know what I'm doing here. My outro is way too long. Hope you enjoyed. Shout out to Davey and Zemrock, really cool teams.